Hello friends, welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video tutorial, this is basically introductory to java.util.Collections class. So basically, when we talk about this class, basically collections class in Java basically consists exclusively of static methods that operate on or return collections. It contains polymorphic algorithms that operate on collections, views, and wrappers, which returns a new collection backed by the specified collection, right? And third point, saying that the methods of java.util.collections class all throw null pointer exception if the collections or class objects provided to them are null. So there are a lot of methods, a static method in this class. If you pass parameter as a null, then this is going to throw a null pointer exception, right? And most of the methods are a static method, or you can understand as a utility class, utility methods basically. So if you want to calculate like a sort, if you want to perform kind of sorting, if you want to calculate mix, mean, max, shuffle, reverse order. So these are basically utility methods which helps you to perform some specific task on to provide a collection. There are a lot of methods which is in polymorphic in nature. Like if you have a sort, right? Sort method, basically there you can pass any kind of list implementation classes, and that's what we used to tell. This algorithm basically supports polymorphic algorithm, right? So these are the key points always you will have to keep in mind when we talk about the collections class in java.util package. Now let's try to understand a couple of methods through an example. So here I have created an example. It's a very pretty straightforward example. So here I have created a list that is called person list, and here I have added few names of the person, and here simply I'm printing original list. So this list will be printed, right? So toString method will be called basically, and list will be printed in the double bracket, right? So now I'm calling the sort method of list, and sort method basically here you can pass any kind of list implementation, and that's why this is called polymorphic in nature. Here you can pass any class which basically implements a list interface, like you can pass a vector, array list, link list, etc., right? So that's what this algorithm basically supports you to perform polymorphic in nature, right? So here once you pass this list, then list will be sorted in the ascending order by default, right? And make sure that whatever list you are passing and whatever object we have added in that list, those objects basically comparable object. So here basically we have added a string class object, right? And if you go to the string class object, you'll see a string class object implements comparable interface, right? This implements comparable interface. So object of this class is always comparable, right? If you are going to add some custom object in this list, right, then make sure that your collection is comparable, right? So anyway, that for collection, how we can sort a collection for custom class, how we can perform for the custom class like person, employee, etc., we'll see in the separate video tutorial. No need to worry about this right now, right? So that's about your sort method. You pass the collection, and collection will be sorted based on the ascending order or natural ordering. So here if you add a string, any wrapper class, so all wrapper classes basically implements a comparable interface, like in integer, long, float, whichever starts from the capital letter, all classes implements comparable interface. So you don't need to worry about the basically implementing comparable interface. But you, if you are going to add a custom object, then of course as a developer, your responsibility to implement your class a comparable interface, or you may use a comparator as well. So you have a overloaded method. There is one more sort method which basically takes list as an argument, first argument, second is the comparator. So that we will see separately what's the difference between basically comparable and comparator. We'll take it separately. So here basically we are talking about the sort method which takes only one parameter, and this whatever collection we are passing, make sure that that implements list interface. Now here this will print in the sorted order of person will be so in the sorted order, right? In ascending order. If you have a string, means ascending order. Now next method we are going to take, we want to reverse this. What here we are doing the sorting. Now collection you have sorted because of this line of code. Now we are going to reverse whatever list you are printing over here. We want to reverse order, right? So that's what this is, a reverse. So this collection will be basically reverse order, that will be given elements in the reverse order. So that's the reverse. And make sure that every methods, if you pass any in these methods, if you pass null as an argument, that then this is going to throw null pointer exception. So here this method will reverse the your collection. Now shuffle basically that will shuffle the all the elements inside the your collection, means that will put elements in the random order, that will not follow any specific order. Now shuffle, after shuffle, you see elements will be printing in the random order. Now we have a collections dot frequency. Here we are passing this list and here we are passing AMI. So how many times this object is occurrence of this object in this collection, that count will be printed. So AMI, here you can see AMI is coming twice, right? List can maintain the duplicates. So here frequency would be the 2. Let's run this application and see the output. So here you can see first of all basically we have printed the original list. So list is getting printed, and list always maintains the order. So in same order, whatever order we have added elements, in same order elements are getting printed. Now now we have called the sort method, and that's the reason now you can see this list is sorted in ascending order, right? Now we have reversed this list. So exactly reverse of this output you'll get over here, right? Reverse, that's the use of reverse method. Now we have a shuffle, right? Shuffle means elements is going to put in this collection in random order, right? So and that's what you are getting output like this. And finally we have called the frequency method, and we are looking occurrence of how many times this is basically available in this collection. So AMI is coming twice, so that's the count to 2 is coming over here. So that's all guys, this is the just an overview on java.util.collection class. So here we have looked into the few APIs or few methods. In next series of video tutorials we'll explore most of the methods which is available in the collections classes, right? Collection class. So still there are a lot of many more methods which is very very useful when you work on the real-time project. So we'll see most frequently used method in next series of video tutorials. Guys, big thank you for watching this video, and if you really like this video, then please hit on the like button, and don't forget to share and subscribe my videos as well.